Let's talk about Aaron Mills, his career with Cameo and beyond, and how his Spector base reaches farther and wider than you could possibly imagine. Aaron Mills started playing the bass at an early age, but because he only had a guitar, his father told him to just take off the top two strings. Unconventional, sure, but Aaron got the job done. He studied jazz at North Carolina Central University under legendary trumpet player Donald Byrd, and right after college in 1978, he was playing a show with his band New Central Connection. They shared the stage with other big acts like Frankie Beverly and this band called Cameo. Right after that show, Aaron got a phone call.
And it was Larry Blackman on the other end. He says to Aaron, "Will you come to New York to play?" I said, "Well, why not? Send me a plane ticket. I'll be up there as soon as you send a ticket." And he sent the ticket. He sent me a ticket on a Monday. And I flew to New York. And that Wednesday, we went and played in Cincinnati, Cameo. I think Bootsy Collins was on the show, somebody like that. But it was a big concert, and we had a ball, man. Really had a ball.
A year later in 1979, Aaron walked into Sam Ash and saw a Spector hanging on the wall.
And I was getting ready to leave out, and I turned around and told the guy there, I said, "Let me play that bass." Seemed like the bass said something to me. It was built neck through, and I dug that, first of all. Rare that you run into a bass, you know, built one piece of wood. I said, "Damn, I gotta have this." Anyway, I played it, and it was smoking, man. I love the bass.
He bought the bass for $750 and took it straight to a Cameo show in Milwaukee. By the time they got there, the finish on the bass was cracked, so Aaron called up Stu to see what he could do.
Hello.
Stu invited him to the Brooklyn shop, where he gave him a bass without a finish on it. Later, he also got another Spector, which, as he describes it...
Oh, it was so powerful, I could barely play it. It was like having a car with two engines in it. I would play this thing up, and it would just blow everybody away. And my sound guy told me, he said, "Man, you got to do something about that bass. Powerful." We were doing shows with Rick James, everybody then, and I was just blowing cats away with that bass. Everybody loved that bass.
It was at this moment that Aaron Mills changed everything. An incredible player plus an incredible instrument is a recipe for historic records. Aaron used his Spector on the 1980 Cameo albums Cameosis and Feel Me, which propelled the band to new heights commercially. Cameosis reached number one on the R&B album charts, and the song Shake Your Pants peaked at number eight on the R&B singles chart. That same year, Cameo released the album Feel Me, which included the song Keep It Hot, which charted even higher at number 6 on the R&B charts. Now, here's the thing about Shake Your Pants and Keep It Hot. They weren't just top-charting songs that ramped up Cameo's success. They've also been sampled over and over by artists like Boyz II Men, Mac Dre, and Beastie Boys. Here, does this sound familiar?
Stab through the neighborhood, D's spinning, we's winning, strapped with the John Lennon, headrests, TVs in them, best in the nation on this PlayStation.
What about this?
But just think, I used to sell them weights, but now I'm all off into real estate. We put our city on the map, raised clientele, made it so...
All right, wild card. Do you recognize this?
Gdzieś na gorącej niwie w Łodzi lub dalej. Spotkałem kiedyś taką lalę. Wygląd supermodelki, zakres słów jednych. Gdy otworzyła usta, mówiła o jednym.
Maybe it was the fact that Aaron Mills' bass playing was already in so many hip-hop songs that he got the call, or knock, I guess, for his next gig. One night in the year 2000, Aaron flew home from Japan. Tired and jet-lagged, he came home, unpacked, and settled in. Then at 4 a.m., he heard a knock at the door.
When I woke up, I thought I was in Japan. I'm still dreaming, right? So it's this roadie named Shy Boy. He says, "You want to record with the Outkast?" I really didn't know who the Outkast was. And I said, "Yeah, okay, okay." So they call me in, and we go to the studio 4 in the morning. I'm trying to wake up, and Dre says, hey, man, you want to play on some stuff? I said, yeah. Gosh, he put the track up. It was Sorry, Miss Jackson. I bust that track in one take. Great track. But, man, it wasn't no problem. It was just a matter of locking in with the drums and doing it, you know, and just making it my song. That's all I did. Yeah.
Aaron Mills continued to expand his playing, working with other artists like CeeLo Green, Gwen Stefani, and Organized Noise. Because what happens when you have a car with two engines? You go places. Aaron Mills has since passed along his Spector to his son, Brandon, who currently plays bass for Leon Bridges. I think it's safe to say you definitely don't need those top two strings. That's the power of a good bass line.